Hi everyone, welcome to the next video in my Hobby Basics series. We're going to be looking at how I go about painting Orc or Orruk skin tone. Now I recently posted a photo of this guy, which was a colour mix test I wanted to do just before I went ahead and painted the Orcs from the Prophecy of the Wolf box set for my son, so we could get some games in. It's a little bit darker than I was hoping, but when I posted it up on Instagram, I had loads and loads of requests for the mix and also for a tutorial, so I thought it would make a good subject for one of my Hobby Basic videos. So let's get on with painting him. Okay, so this is the orc head, all undercoated black. And the first thing we want to do is take some Deathworld Forest. Like that. And we want to water this down. It's a 50-50 mix of water to paint, like that. And what we want to do is, moving the brush quickly, we want to start laying down a nice solid base coat. Now, don't have to worry about any of the detail. You can just base coat the whole head in the same color, just keeping the brush moving. Not getting tempted to go back over an area. Just want to get the paint on, let it dry, and then we can start adding more layers until we get a nice solid base coat. Very patchy at the minute, but don't panic. Okay, so that's the first coat. Now, what I'll do is I'll go away, let this dry, and I'll apply another couple of coats until we get a nice solid base coat. If you do the same, and we can come back and we can get on with the start of the shading. Okay, so this is just finishing off the base coat. This was four coats to get a nice solid coverage. Moving on to the first of the shading stages now, which is Incubi Darkness, which is a really nice bluey green. We're going to need to water this down quite a lot to a wash consistency. And what we want to do is start washing in the Incubi Darkness into all of these recesses. These orc faces, they've got some great detail sculpted into them. So we're going to let the washes actually do a lot of the work for us. Speeds things up quite a lot. Don't have to worry too much about being very neat. So we can tidy it up as we go. Just focus on getting this nice shade to all the recesses. Okay, so that's that stage done. I wouldn't be tempted to use a hairdryer on this now to speed it up. So we want the wash to sit in those recesses and dry naturally. And if you use a hairdryer, it's just going to blow that wash right out of those recesses and ruin the effect we're trying to get. So we'll leave that dry and then we'll come back and do another shading stage. Okay, so that's the first shade all nice and dry now. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to the second shade stage, which is Incubi Darkness and Rhinox Hide. It's a 50-50 mix. We're going to water that down again. It's a nice wash consistency. What we're going to do is apply this in and around the eyes, darken that a little bit more, a bit more contrast. Nose, around the mouth. Deepest little recesses. Okay, so that's that little stage done. Okay, so that's that shade dry now, so we can start moving on to the highlight stages. For this one, you will need Deathworld Forest, Rakarth Flesh, and Screaming Skull. And it's two parts Deathworld Forest to one part Rakarth Flesh and one part Screaming Skull. That. Now you're going to need to add about the same amount of water again, so it's nice and thin. Okay, so what we're going to do then is we're going to start focusing the highlight on the raised areas of the skin. So those cheekbones, tops of these ears. Tops of his nose. Start picking out the bottom lip. Protrudes quite a lot, so it's going to pick up a lot of the light.
So this year. So I want to catch these wrinkles on his forehead. To the bottom of that jaw. Okay, so that's the first of the highlighting stages done. It's looking pretty good now. So what we'll do now, we'll add another highlight stage, which will be Deathworld Forest again and Screaming Skull, and a 50-50 mix. Like that. Again, we're going to water this down quite a bit. It's more of a glaze. Like that. Okay, and what we're going to do now is we're going to do pretty much the same as we just did, but
covering less area. So we're going to refine these highlights. We're just still focusing on the tops of where we think the light would catch, the tops of these eyebrows. Top of his nose. These big jutting out cheekbones. His ears, focusing on the tips. Again, on the tops of his lips. Not forgetting about the wrinkles on his forehead.
Okay, so that's the second highlighting stage done. So move on to third highlight, which will be just pure Screaming Skull. We're going to water this down again quite heavily to a nice glaze consistency. What we're going to do now with this is we're just going to keep it on the very tips, the highest points.
Picking out those sharp points on his cheekbones, tip of his nose. Light would catch on his nostrils there. Tips of these lips. Tips of these ears. The tops of these wrinkles.
Okay, so that's the third highlight done. What we really need to start doing now is start to punch some colour into the skin. It's looking very green, a bit boring, not very alive. If you look at normal skin tones, they're made up of lots of different colours. So what we're going to do, we're going to start to shade some of the recesses with some reds and some purples, make it a little bit more interesting. So to do that, what we're going to need is some Khorne Red and Screaming Skull mix, 50-50. Water it down, a nice glaze consistency. Like that. What we're gonna do, start to glaze on
some color onto this bottom lip.
Like that. And
I also want to do the
tips of his ears.
You can
do a lot more if you really wanted to.
Anywhere where the skin is going to be tight against the
skull, maybe, so the cheekbones. You don't want to go too over the top, though. You don't want the skin to lose its
greenness.
Just some little nuances here and there, just to make the skin a little bit more interesting. So I think that's all we'll do there. Okay, so what we'll take then is some Khorne Red on its own. Again, I'm going to water that down heavily to a nice glaze consistency. Like that. What we want to do is
punch some more colour into recesses. dropping in
the Khorne Red glaze
into the deepest recesses. Don't want to do it too much. Just here and there.
Make him look a little bit more alive. When it's dry, it won't look as intense as that.
Take some of that out of there, actually. Tip of his nose as well.
Okay, so that red glaze now is not as intense as it was looking on the camera just now. Well, now it's all dry. So, like I said, I want to take some Xereus Purple and I'm going to water that down to a nice glaze consistency. This is very, very
controlled glaze now, just in that socket there.
And the same
the other side.
So that's the purple glaze around the eye sockets dry now. So we can move on to the final highlight. Which is pure white scar, watered down again to glaze consistency like that. And what we're going to do is now this is just a final, almost a dot highlight
on the very tips. Eyebrows, those cheekbones, the top of his nose. Tips of his ears.
And what I will then start to do, paint in some detail
onto this bottom lip. tops of the wrinkles, maybe. Little dot.
Okay, so that's pretty much the skin done now, but obviously there's some detail on there, like the eyes and the teeth that I'll need to pick out. So I'll go away now and I'll black those details out, ready to paint. If you do the same, and we'll come back in a minute. Okay, so that's the teeth all blacked out now and his eyeballs. So this is quite a quick stage. So what I will do is we need to take some Balor Brown, like that. Add a bit of water to it, 50-50 mix. Now we're going to take Ushabti Bone. Now we're not mixing these, so just such a quick steps that there's no point actually cutting away. And then we will take some White Scar. All of these watered down with a 50-50 mix. And what we're going to do is we're just going to
start to paint in those teeth, brushing upwards. Be careful not to get any paint on any of the skin that we've just been painting. Take a couple of coats. Trying to get the brush to the other side without covering it all up. Bit fiddly, but we spent so much time on the skin, we don't want to mess it up at this stage.
Okay, so that's the teeth base coat done. What we're going to do now is we're going to take some of our watered down Ushabti bone,
and you just want to come all the way almost to the bottom, start highlighting these teeth. Keeping the brush moving upwards so the colour is strongest at the top. Moving on to the other teeth. Keeping the Balor Brown visible at the bottom. Orks aren't renowned for their dental hygiene.
Like that. Then finally take the white scar, pure white scar that we mixed up, that we watered down, and we want to start the final highlight on the teeth. Just focusing on the tips. And now what I will also take is some Agrax Earthshade Gloss. And I don't water this down at all. What I do is
apply it to the bottoms of the teeth in the mouth recess. What this does, it just sort of shades down the bottom of his teeth as well. Makes him a bit darker. Knocks back the Balor Brown a little bit. And because it's gloss, it'll give a nice little subtle sheen
to his top lip and make it look like he's drooling a little bit. Fits in with the orcs. Okay, so I think that's the teeth done. So we'll move on to those eyes and that'll be it. Again, this stage is very, very quick. So what we're going to do, I'm going to take all three colours in one go. Show you each. Watered down Khorne Red 50-50 mix. Take a little bit of Troll Slayer Orange as well. 50-50 again with water. And Tau Light Ochre. Again, we're not mixing these together, so don't mix this into one giant mix, otherwise it's not going to look right. Again, 50-50 mix with water. So what we'll do is we'll take the Khorne Red. And we very carefully going to paint in that red eyeball. I don't know if you can even see that. It is in there. Okay, so the two eyeballs painted in. Now we're going to take some Troll Slayer Orange. I have to check the name. And
in the center of that eyeball, we're going to drop paint a little dot.
You see that?
Again. On the other eye. If you accidentally get paint on an area you don't want, if you're lucky, if you're quick, you can sometimes flood that area with water very, very quickly. And then dry your brush.
And that sort of saves your paint work. Doesn't always work, but it's worth giving it a shot sometimes. And this is your Tau Light Ochre. And then this is
your final little dot in this very center of that orange dot.
Like that. Okay, so now the eyes are done. What I want to do, final stage, is to put a little highlight on the eyelids. And for that, what we'll do is we'll use some pure Screaming Skull.
Very carefully. Let's add a little highlight
to the eyelid. Same for the other one. And there you go. Okay, so that's the orc head done. I hope you enjoyed the video, and it's encouraged you to give it a go on some of your own orcs or aurochs. And I'll see you in the next video real soon. And remember, if you guys enjoyed watching this video, hit that thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. And if you got any questions, leave them in the comments section below. And I'll see you guys back here soon.